Joining us now, the chairwoman of the Republican National Committee, Ronna Romney McDaniel. Chairwoman McDaniel, thanks for being here this morning.
Thanks for having me.
I wanted to get your reaction to several top Republicans, members of President Trump's own party, your party obviously as well. Senator Rubio saying the organizers of events which inspired the Charlottesville terrorist attack are 100% to blame, saying, Mr. President, the white supremacy groups will see 50% of the blame as a win. Former Governor Jeb Bush, I urge the president to unite the country, not parse the blame. And I want to put this one up on the screen. This is from former Governor Mitt Romney, obviously your uncle, reacting to the president saying there's blame on both sides. He said, no, not the same. One side is racist, bigoted, Nazi. The other opposes racism and bigotry, morally different universes. Do you agree?
Well, the president condemned the white supremacists and the KKK and the neo-Nazis unequivocally.
But it took 48 hours for him to do that.
But he did it, and he should have, and he did. And our party has, across the board, said this is unacceptable. We have no place in our party at all for KKK, anti-Semitism, race, racism, bigotry. It has no place in the Republican Party. There is no home here. We don't want your vote. We don't support you. We'll speak out against you. The president has said so, the vice president, leaders across our party. This is the beginning of what needs to be a longer conversation. We are seeing this rhetoric ramp up. We are seeing more violence, and we need to take a stand against
it. But you know what I'm asking about here. You heard from your uncle last night saying this is not the same when you parse the blame, saying there's blame on both sides. He said one side is racist, bigoted. These are morally different universes. Do you agree with that?
When it comes to Charlottesville, the blame lays squarely at the KKK and the white supremacists who organized this rally and put together an entire event around hate and bigotry.
So you disagree with the president?
I'm saying the president did the right thing condemning it. I'm saying absolutely the events that transpired in Charlottesville were initiated by this white supremacist KKK rally. But it would not have happened if those people had not come together in hate. So and there were peaceful protesters who did the right thing, coming out against it.
You had the RNC. So how does the Republican Party defend then what the president said yesterday in pointing out that there were fine people on both sides, that both sides should share the blame here?
Well, first of all, we have to unequivocally say that the KKK and the white supremacists were wrong. I do think people may have showed up in Charlottesville thinking, hey, this is going to be a discussion about whether we remove historic statues. The second they saw Nazi flags, they should have turned tail. The second you join a group that has a Nazi flag or is joining the KKK, there's no good there. There's no good KKK member. There's no nice neo-Nazi. This is not a Republican or Democrat issue. This is un-American what they're doing. And it's going to take bipartisanship to bring people together around unifying this country. And the president has called for that.
As you know, during the campaign, then candidate Donald Trump repeatedly made a promise that he would be able to unite the nation better than Hillary Clinton. He said he was the unifier. I want you to listen to this.
I think the thing that will surprise people, I'll be a unifier. I think I'll bring people together. And that includes blacks and whites and everything. I think people will come together.
Do you think what he said yesterday unified the American people?
I think condemning white supremacy and KKK and neo-Nazism was a first step.
Sharing the blame is what he said yesterday.
I don't think comparing blame works in this situation because we know what initiated the violence and the death of this young woman whose life was taken too soon. But I do think, and I'm going to say this about President Trump, he is a Republican candidate who came to my state of Michigan during the campaign and campaigned in Detroit in the black churches.
And you were there just this week. But I'm curious, the same people you talked to in Detroit this week,
yeah,
how they would react to the former leader of the KKK, David Duke, coming out, as we reported here, and thanking the president for his honesty and his courage yesterday.
Oh, I think that makes everybody's stomach turn. And I think it makes the president's stomach turn. He has condemned David Duke. David Duke has nothing to do with the Republican Party. He's going to try and get his name into the headlines. That's why we have to condemn him and white supremacy at every level. And it's going to take bipartisanship, leadership coming together to say this is unacceptable. It's not something we want for this country. It's not something I want for my kids. I don't want them seeing this as part of our country's dialogue. So we're going to work together and speak out against it.
But is something going wrong then when you're getting thanked by the former head of the KKK? You had Senator Marco Rubio, who I mentioned. If you begin assigning blame, saying only part of the blame lays with white supremacists who were there in Charlottesville,
I don't think
they're going to feel like this is a victory.
I don't think David Duke is thanking the president for condemning, which he did, white supremacy, neo-Nazism,
but to share the blame, he liked what he heard yesterday.
The the president was saying that the violence escalate, people brought violence from both sides, and violence isn't okay. But the blame lays squarely at the KKK, the white supremacists, the neo-Nazis who organized this rally, caused violence, and are pushing hate across this country.
Chairwoman McDaniel, I thank you for your time this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.